What's up everyone, welcome back to the channel. As you guys may know, iOS 13.3 just came out, so we're going to take a look at it on the iPhone 7. Now this update, as I've said in other videos, it was a big update and a small update. It was a big update kind of in, you know, the changes and the bug fixes and stuff. And it was kind of a big update in terms of the size of it, but it was kind of like a medium update in my opinion. Now before I get too far in this, I will leave the whole changelog in the description below so you guys can see all the changes and everything with 13.3. I'm literally not going to talk about everyone because that would take about 45 minutes for me to talk about. Also, a quick thing, I'll go ahead and do speed tests tomorrow. I know you guys love those things and I'm so infrequent with them, but you guys keep telling me to do them. So I'll go ahead and do a 13.2.3 versus 13.3 on the iPhone 7 as well as probably the 6S and 8. Tomorrow, so keep a lockdown on the channel. I won't let you guys down about that. But in this update, there were a couple cool changes. Like I said, this update was about 400 megabytes or so. I think I screenshotted the size, and no, I didn't. I did not screenshot the size, but it was about, you know, 400 megabytes or so. And a cool thing is within settings now, one of the main features is within screen time. So you can now actually create limits. So basically, the amount your kid can use phone calls, FaceTimes, iMessage, whatever. You can now set those limits within iOS 13.3. Before, we did not have that capability apparently, but now we have that capability, which is really, really cool. And also you can now change the contact list for your kids. So if you want to go ahead and have your kids contact you or someone else, you can now change that within screen times, which is cool. Me personally, I don't have any kids, so it's not going to affect me at all, but it might affect you and you might like that. So it's a really cool feature and I'm glad Apple added that in. Another cool little thing is within photos. So before, when you edited a photo, whatever the case, it would actually overwrite that main video. Actually, I meant video, not photo, but I can't really find any videos that I took before to demonstrate this. Maybe I took one. No, I honestly, basically whenever you would take a video and you would, you know, edit it up in the Photos app, it would overwrite that video. Now within iOS 13.3, you have the capability to either overwrite it or you can save it as a new video, which is really cool. So you don't have to necessarily overwrite the video every single time. You can go and create another one if you want to retain and maintain that old one. So that's really, really cool. And I'm actually happy Apple put that in. Within iOS 13.3, there's also a new feature. So you can now, it basically adds support for NFC, USB, and Lightning FIDO2 compliant security keys. So you now have that capability within iOS 13.3. So if you ever needed to use that capability, you now have it with 13.3. Again, doesn't really affect me, but it might affect you. And that's really, really cool. Another small little issue within iOS 13.3 two and earlier versions was if you screenshotted something and you went and sent it, sometimes that screenshot would become blurry and you might not even realize it, but the person on the other end might. Now with 13.3, that is fixed. So now you won't have that issue when you're sending it via messages or iMessage or whatever the case is. Also, another issue was within markup. So sometimes you would mark things up, sometimes you would erase things, whatever the case is. And sometimes you might not even notice it, but they would not save to photos. So sometimes you would do things and it wouldn't save to photos, but now that is now fixed. So that is really, really cool, and luckily, hopefully that didn't happen to you, but if it does now, it'll be fixed, so I won't even worry about it. That pretty much covers up everything I wanted to hit on. I'll go ahead and show you guys the benchmark scores I had before. On a previous version of iOS, so October 28th, man, this was forever ago, I had a multi-core score of 130,256, and the score did go up, I think. And I don't think that's right, 210,460, there's no way that's right, let me double check. And that is right. So I guess it went up 210,460. That is pretty insane. Do I notice it being that fast? I mean, it's a pretty fast phone for how old it is. Maybe it is that fast. I don't know. I'll go ahead and drop that speed test tomorrow. I have another iPhone on 13.2.3. So I'll go ahead and see how both of them compare. But that's pretty crazy. At the end of it, I would recommend you guys to update. You can still jailbreak on any version of iOS. You just need to make sure you put your phone in DFU mode before you plug it into Check Rain. But that's pretty much it, guys. If you have any other questions or anything, leave it down in the comment section below. Hit that like button, that would mean so much, but definitely hit that subscribe button. Every single subscriber that we get really does count, so it would mean so much if you guys could hit that. Also, check out the other links down in the description as well. My Twitter, my Instagram, my second channel, all those links are linked down below. I'd really appreciate it if you guys could check it out. But more importantly than everything else, I love every single one of you guys. Hopefully I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out to them.